Anthropic AI has launched the Claude Sonnet 4.5 model, and they say this is the best coding model out there. So in this video, we are going to compare Sonnet 4.5 and GPT-5. If you look at the model comparison, Claude Sonnet 4.5 easily outperforms GPT-5 in most of the coding benchmarks. So we are going to compare by using some LeetCode problems, and here I'm having a bunch of HTML, CSS and JavaScript prompts. So let's get started. So first, let's go with a big game, okay, which is create me a snake egg eater game in HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Make it the best game ever made by a human in single file. So let's see what both this model gives for this prompt. The interesting thing about this prompt is I give total freedom because I'm literally asking them to make it the best game ever made by a human. So it's going to be really interesting how they come up with in the output. So let's see now. That took quite some time from both these models, and just look at the lines of code for a single snake game. Even GPT-5, like, obviously just spit all the code it has, this many lines of code. So first, let's go with GPT-5, okay? And here we are having the preview option. Let me just click it. Let me pause for a while, and this looks quite interesting. It has a lot of options going on, features going on. First is the speed, higher equal to faster the speed, okay? Calls on and off, wrap on and off, and we're having how to play instructions, controls, we are having volume, we are having grid size. Okay, the grid size also increases. Yep. Okay, that looks pretty good. This doesn't look bad at all. Let me see what happens when I die. Okay, it has even got the sound and stuff. That's a pretty solid game. And we're even having a high score, so let me go to a new game. And the high score still prevails over here. So that's overall a really good thing. We're having the length, score, resume new game, and the speed and other stuff. GPT-5, as usual, has done a neat job. So let's go and see the newcomer, which is 4.5, and I'll go here. So I think I cannot see the rest of the stuff over here. So what I will do is, let me simply download it as a HTML and open it. So let me just minimize it. I'm not sure if it's responsive enough for the browser. And similar to GPT-5, it has also got quite a few options. We're having the medium, easy, hard and insane, start and pause, high score and stuff. And it has also given me the instructions. So let's see, let me go with medium. So I think we need to get a sound. Okay. Okay, we aren't getting any sound over here. So you just notice, right? I'm not getting any sound over here. And moreover, in ChatGPT, I had way more customizable options. For example, I had the way to customize the volume, walls, wrap, and the sound, and also the speed. 4.5 as given, the only customizable option that I see over here is the easy, medium, hard, and insane. Apart from that, I'm not having way more customizable things. So I think overall, both these models have done a great job, have implemented the game perfectly. The UI looks stunning in both the cases. But I feel GPT-5 has gone a level bit more in adding customization of stuffs. So the next one is going to be quite a famous prompt. Give me a HTML code that shows a ball bouncing inside a spinning rectangle, and the ball should be affected by gravity and friction, and it shouldn't come out of the rectangle walls. Let's see what both these models use for this. This is the one from Claude Sonnet 4.5, and that's spot on, 10 on 10 over here. Literally has done the job. There's a rectangle spinning and the ball is perfectly moving in alignment with the gravity, and it's not coming out of the rectangle. That's perfect. Now let's see the same with GPT-5, and it hasn't given me the preview inside ChatGPT itself. So let me just copy the code and go to a online HTML viewer, and I'm going to paste it. Okay, a lot of things are going on over here. Let me just open it in a new tab. Okay, this is what I am getting. We are having some omega restitution. I don't know what is even that. Friction. So it's gravity plus friction plus rotating walls and collisions. And To be honest, it has done the job. The rectangle is spinning, and I really like the design of the rectangle. It's the lines and the background is different. It has done the job perfectly. I don't know why there is a toothpick kind of thing onto the ball. So it says click canvas to kick the ball. Okay, you saw that, right? Okay, that's going too fast. So if I click inside the canvas, the ball is going like super fast. So if I do it again, the speed is just increasing. And drag or press reset. So here we are having the, okay, here we are having an option to even control the spin of the rectangle. Okay, that's crazy. Okay, now it's spinning so slow. Okay, now it's going to get fast a bit. Here we are having the friction. That's just stunning how much option it has given for me. But these are two different things. Okay, so we asked for a prompt. 4.5 has given us the perfect response. And when it comes to GPT-5, I really feel it has gone that 1% extra. I guess that's where still GPT-5 has its own USP, that going 1% extra from what the user has wanted. Well, basically it depends on that person who is going to ask a prompt. If I'm going to be a user who only wants what I need, this is perfect. I can live with it. But there could be some people who don't really know what they want, or they'll be fine to accept any new changes. So in that case, for those people, this will be like so amazing as a response. Next, let's go with this prompt. Create a HTML, CSS, JavaScript code to simulate movement of all planets around the sun using animation in a single file. Let's see what both these models gives. First, let's go with Sonnet 4.5, and it has done a stunning job. Let me just open it in a new tab and we can drag this and explore. So here we are having the sun, and another great thing about this is it has beautifully replicated each and every planet. Like Saturn has that ring, even the color also. For example, Earth has that green and water tone. So it has also done a pretty good job, and the pace at which each are rotating, I guess it's aligned with the rotation speed also. And apart from that, we are having pause, we are having the speed up and speed down. This is what I want from Sonnet 4.5, something extra. Okay, I didn't ask for this play, pause, speed up and speed down, but it has done this at the moment. So as usual, I'm going to copy it, planets.html. So I'll just go here, maybe refresh this and paste it. Okay, so let me open this. Okay, so what's happening here? We have got all the planets, and I'm not sure why everything is spinning on the sun. Or maybe like, maybe is this a top view or something. Okay, show orbits. I'm having the trail also, and we are also even having the thing. We can even get the info. That's good. The background looks good. I'm having a pause option, reset option. Okay, this is cause of the trail, and we are having the time scale also. Let me play it. Okay, time scale is basically the speed. Okay, that looks good. The only thing that confuses me over here is why all these planets are spinning on the sun. You can literally see this, right? The sun is here and everything is literally spinning on it, whereas here you see, right, it has the orbit perfectly like circled, and we are getting that radiation from the sun. But here it's more onto the sun itself. Of course, it has given us plenty of additional options. As usual, GPT-5 does that. We can get the information, angle, orbit, the days. We can show the orbit, trails and stuff. But the core thing like is missed over here. So I think for this prompt, I'm going to go with 4.5. It has done a terrific job. This is going to be my prompt. Code a big bird using HTML. Show the side view of the bird flying in one single file. This prompt may sound so simple, but believe me, none of the models have given good results for this prompt. Very few. So let's see what both these models gives for this. And this is the view that it has given. And I think it has done a good job. We have got the bird and we have got its wings. The legs look good. We are having some clouds kind of things. Maybe I can just get the full view. Yep, we are having the clouds, and the most important thing is it's not distorted. Like even if you ask this like what creature is this to a 5-year kid, the kid can literally say it's a bird. So it's identifiable. Previous models that I used this prompt, it wasn't even like a bird, it was like a new alien species. So the eyes, I really like that, you know, that white thing inside that black circle. So that's good, call that retina, I guess. So Claude 4.5, splendid job again. And this is what GPT-5 is giving. And okay, this is what I said, right? The bird that, okay, why is it going outside the screen? Okay, yeah, just look at this, right? It has got certain things well, like the ground, greenish ground, the clouds look much better than 4.5, but the main focus is on the bird, and the beaks are good, the body and the other stuff just doesn't look like a bird. This is what I told you, right? When I tried this prompt with so many models, it just looks distorted and nobody can identify what species it is. But 4.5 has done a great job. It's identifiable, it's simple and perfect. So this one, I'm going to give it for 4.5. So it's quite a tough competition. Earlier, I thought GPT-5 was like giving those extra stuff and was good, but now it's levels. So now let's go with the lead code hard problem. And here I'm having the valid number problem. This is an extremely hard problem. The reason is because the acceptance rate is just 22%, and just around 400,000 has been accepted from 2.2 million submissions. So it's an insanely difficult problem. And let's see what both these models does for this. We have got the solution. First, let's go with 4.5. Let me just copy this and go here. So we just need the class alone. So paste it. We don't need this int main, like the sample data and stuff. Let me remove this and remove this also. Yep. So we have got the result, and it beats 100% in runtime and number one, and in memory it beats 63%. So that's an amazing result, to be honest, because this is an extremely difficult problem. And next, let's go with GPT-5. And GPT-5 has got a better response. It has got 100% and it has got 87%. And if you remember, Claude 4.5 got 60-odd some percent. So not a big difference, but just stating the number. So as a conclusion, what I will say is Sonnet 4.5 is such a amazing model. So the reason why I am saying is because when we compared both GPT-5 and Sonnet 4.5, there wasn't even a single place where it felt bad. The response of Sonnet felt bad. It really did what we gave in the prompt in a perfect manner. So even in that bird prompt also, GPT-5 couldn't even generate a proper error. Sonnet literally did an amazing job. So I really feel it performs on par with GPT-5 model, and in some cases it really outperforms GPT-5. But there are also some scenario where Sonnet 4.5 just sticks to the prompt itself and doesn't do something out of the box. But when it comes to doing out of the box and adding more features than the user has requested, I feel at that point GPT-5 also does an amazing job. Do let me know in the comments what you feel about it. Check the playlist of my channel, done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.